I sold it all. Oh my gosh. I sold it all. I must be broke.
What's up, guys? I'm Brandon Young. On this channel, I teach you how to make, save, and invest money. So if you're new here, consider subscribing and don't forget to hit that bell so you don't miss a beat. So man, oh man, the stock portfolio that I had and I've been building it for so long, I pretty much sold it all. And literally, like, I'm in such dismay because, like, I spent so much time building it. Like, one of my favorite stocks that I had in that portfolio was Chegg. Now, if you don't know what Chegg is, it's that textbook company that they came out pretty much helping kids rent textbooks for cheap, and they kind of steadily went into tutoring and a whole bunch of different items. But I bought their stock for $5 and I was like, you know, I really see this going somewhere. And fast forward 3-4 years later, their stock went up to 65. So did really well on that one. And the next one, which was probably one of my best stocks in my portfolio, was PayPal. Now, I saw the potential of PayPal from the beginning. Like, I knew e-commerce was gonna be big. And as you know, when you pay for stuff online, you're usually gonna use an online terminal, and I just seen PayPal as that means. Now, I bought PayPal at $33, and I think PayPal was at like what, 160, 170? If I was not mistaken, it's around there, but that was like one of my best stocks. And another good one that I had in the list was the Match Group. Now, if you don't know, the Match Group is pretty much the people that own all the dating apps, so Hinge, Tinder, all of the above, they own basically all of those dating apps. And I'm like, wow, we're in a freaking generation where everybody's on dating apps, so it makes sense to invest in a company that does nothing but dating apps, because this is where we're going in the future. Now, I've been steadily growing this portfolio year after year, adding money to it, just being that person that promotes stocks and investing and just doing your own due diligence and putting your money into the stock market, and it's so great. But I actually came to the realization of something, and I want you guys to actually listen. When it actually comes down to the numbers and you take a close look at stocks, when you're doing it at like such a low quantity, especially if you have certain goals for yourself, where I want to be able to create like great passive income for myself, I feel like if you're not gonna do it big with stocks, because the only way you're really gonna make money from dividend payments is if you put large quantities of money. And that's my personal opinion. I know there's gonna be a lot of people disagree with me, but honestly, the only way to create great wealth with stocks is honestly just putting in large quantities of money, especially if you want it to be something passive and you want it to be like dividend stocks. You're not gonna see that much money if you buy one dividend paying stock. You're gonna get probably like a couple cents, couple pennies on the dollar for that. So I kind of had to think and shift how I'm actually investing and how I'm actually using my money. Now, I'm in no shape and form telling people not to invest in the stock market, because obviously investing is always great. I always recommend that everybody invest, but you always have to have a plan. You have to know which road you're trying to take. And I think that road where I'm just gonna fully immerse myself in there is going to be real estate. Obviously, I've been talking about real estate a lot, and I feel like that is really the means of growing wealth. Majority of people that I talk to, almost 90% of them, they may have businesses, they may have like a good job, but almost all of them, one of the biggest factors that I see that is in all of their portfolios is real estate. They all have large quantities of real estate. And when you think about real estate, month after month, when your mortgage is getting paid over and over again, especially if you decide to get like a 3-family home or a 2-family home where you have tenants paying you rent, they're paying your mortgage off. You're not paying anything. And you're literally building your net worth month after month, year after year, and it's great. You're getting that steady passive income every single month with that rent payment, as well as you getting your mortgage paid, as well as you're getting tax benefits from being a homeowner slash owning some real estate, and your net worth is going up steadily. Now, I decided I wanted to liquidate all of my stocks. I wanted to completely get rid of it because I wanted to just fully immerse myself in just real estate, because I feel like within the next year, 2 years, 3 years, I feel like I can own multiple properties, and that's gonna be the fast lane to creating great amounts of wealth for myself. So it was pretty much just getting rid of my portfolio for the short term, because in the long term, once I'm able to build all these streams of real estate for myself and create all these different passive income amounts, then I'll be able to invest even more money into the stock market and investing, which will enable me to grow my portfolio faster than I would have if I just kept investing little tiny amounts here and there. I feel like this road makes way more sense for me. And even though I had to kiss all those beautiful gains goodbye, I mean, honestly, when you think about stocks, it's just a means to an end. Like, you're really investing for the end goal. I know a lot of people tell you to invest for the long term, but when it comes to investing, it kind of is just another way to hold your money, if you think about it. Like, you're basically holding equity in a company, and you're just pretty much like, yeah, here, take my money, and we hope that your company does well and the price goes up, and then when I feel the time is right, I'll take my money back out, which is basically what I'm doing. I feel like I've reaped the benefits of investing in these companies so early on. I've seen probably like 800%, 900% growth within Chegg, and about maybe 200 to 300% growth with PayPal. And, you know, obviously they're great companies. They're probably gonna keep continuing to grow, but I need to do something for me. I need this money now because it is going to help me in the long term with my real estate portfolio career. So no, I didn't liquidate because I'm broke. I didn't liquidate because, oh, I need the money and I'm going through financial burden. I did it more so as a means to invest in real estate to help me further along in my path to wealth prosperity. But what do you think about my decision? You think I should have liquidated it all, or you think I should have, you know, kept it? What do you think? Leave your comments in the comment section below. I would love to know your thoughts about this. Watch this video here. Watch this video here. Go subscribe here. I'm Brandon Young, and I'll see you in my next video. Peace.